Yo quisiera que David nos presentara una miembro del board que lo conoce bien y que ha trabajado con él, Diana Piedra. Diana.
I'll just say a few words in English for those of you who don't speak Spanish here. It's really our pleasure to have all of you joining us here on this weekend that's very special, not just to humans, but to Cuban Americans as well, who have been influenced by our parents and our grandparents, passing not only patriotic and cultural values down to us and our siblings as well, but also the values that were dear to my family, as many of you saw in the movie that we shared at 1 o'clock this afternoon. So for us, it's a pleasure to be here and share some time with us, and it's also a pleasure for us to have our congressman, who now represents the district of Key West. If you would like to share a few words, he's taken, has been taking a few hours of his busy schedule to come here and address the top guys, and it's my pleasure to introduce Congressman Dave Rivera.
Thank you very much, Diana. I greatly appreciate it. Cuban culture, Cuban history, and the connection, the ties that bind Cuba with the United States and Cuba particularly with Key West. This has been for certainly decades over a century, but particularly in the last few decades, a great labor of love. And there is no one that has provided that greater leadership and vision and that labor of love than Pedro Pena. So let's get that around. And he's done this, and board members like Diana have done this, and many of you that are here, because you understand something very important that perhaps not everyone understands. And that is that there are generations like Diana and myself, generations of children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren that need to have a place where they can go and understand their history, understand their background, understand the struggles of the founding of a republic, even before the founding of a republic, a place that can be the repository of great thoughts, great thinkers like Felix Varela and José Martí, a place where we can understand the past so that we can have a better future. I can tell you, as a child and grandchild of exile, every time I walk in here, I get chills. Thinking about my parents, my grandparents, my great-grandparents, generations of Cubans that struggle nation. Where else can that happen but here in the San Carlos Institute? Think about the entire exile community. Iconic institutions like the Freedom Tower and what that meant to the exile experience after 1959. This is more than a century of history embodied in the San Carlos Institute. We can never, ever stop supporting and advocating, protecting, and fighting and struggling for the work that Rafael Peña Red, Diana, and so many other board members have done to make that vision, that dream,